Hey, I'm Andy, back at Tennis Warehouse, and today I'm gonna take you through an awesome medicine ball routine that can be used as both a warm-up or as a fitness routine. This is great for building foundational strength as well as working on your footwork. Let's get started. The first thing we're gonna do here with Danielle is just get down the foundational movements. And we wanna work out of both stances, both open and closed stance that you're gonna use from the baseline on your ground stroke. So the first thing we're gonna do here with Danielle, we're gonna go sets of, I like to do about 6 or 8, and we're gonna go just the open stance forehand. And what we're focused on here is we want smooth, efficient movement. We wanna crossover step out to the ball, load on our outside leg, fire it using our hips and our legs, and then crossover step back to recover. And what we wanna avoid doing is kinda skipping out to that wide ball. We wanna walk or run to that ball, as opposed to skip. So here we go, Danielle, ready? Moving out wide, good, and back. Nice, good, crossover step, good, and back. And we wanna kinda always be moving, sometimes laterally, sometimes on a backwards diagonal to absorb a deeper ball. Good, and last one here. Good, and rest, nice. So we'll give her a little 10-second rest here. And normally I like to go a couple sets to each direction, but for the sake of the video, we're just gonna move on to the next movement. So same thing out to the backhand. Here we go. Good, nice, crossover step back. Good, crossover out, good, nice. Crossover out, load that outside leg and fire. Good, very nice. Last three, good, awesome. Last two, really fire with the hips. Good, nice, and last one, really fire with the hips and recover. Good, and rest. So those are our open stance to both the forehand and the backhand side. Now we're gonna work more of the closed stance, and what I want Danielle to do here is making sure, like she's attacking kind of a mid-court ball, I want her to move on a forward diagonal as opposed to laterally on the baseline. Okay, so closed stance forehands here for 6. Ready, here we go. Coming in, good, and recover back, good. Coming in, fire it, good, and recover back. Good. Coming in, fire it, good, nice. Last three, really fire it at me. Nice, good, excellent, last two. Very nice, good, and last one. Awesome, rest, very nice. So Danielle's doing this awesome. Crossover steps to the bowl. When you're doing this right, it's only 3 steps out to your open stance, 4 steps total to your closed stance. That was perfect. Last set here, same thing on the backhand side. Here we go, ready? Coming in, very nice, and recover, good. Very nice, excellent. Good, 3 more. Coming in, cut off that angle, good, nice. Come in, cut off that angle, nice. And last one, coming on in, fire it with the hips, excellent, good. Now we're gonna give her a little bit of a rest and we're gonna progress to another part of the drill. One of the things I love about these drills is there's basically endless possibilities and progressions you can do. The one we're gonna focus on right now is gonna work on Danielle's balance when she's hitting on the move from the corners. So we're gonna work the open stance forehand again first, but what she's gonna do is she's gonna freeze right before she throws the ball to me, freeze right after, and then head back. And what we're gonna make sure in those positions, she's in a strong, balanced position so that she can execute her shot and recover as effectively and efficiently as possible. All right, Danielle, ready? Here you go. So move out, hold, good strong position there. Now fire it. Hold it again, good. And now strong recovery step back, perfect. Again, hold, strong, fire it, good, good, and recover back. That's it, all good, we'll do it again. Hold, fire it, get through that, perfect. Now recover, excellent, great job. What I love, good, fire it, go, good. And I love how Danielle's getting her weight through the ball, sending her weight through the contact point, go, good, excellent, recover back. Last one here, through the contact point, strong recovery step back. Excellent, we'll give her a little 10-second rest. So again, when you're hitting that ball, remember your body energy when you're hitting isn't always going forward into the court, it's always going towards your contact point when you're hitting. So when that ball's wide, you want your body still going wide through that shot, and then you can come back and recover. We're gonna do the same thing to the backhand side here. Ready, here we go. So moving out wide, hold that spot, throw, nice, and recover, good, excellent, very nice, good, strong, go, nice, and recover back, good, get that body going towards the contact point, good, wide ball, nice, good, and recover, excellent, I'm gonna push you back, good, go, nice, good, recover back, excellent, last one, hold, strong, fire it, good, come back, Good, and we'll rest. And now the last set here we'll do after we give Danielle about a 10 to 15 second rest to replicate just like a between point timing. We're gonna go side to side here for six balls. All right, here we go with our last set. Ready? Absorb that deep ball. Good, fire it at me, nice. Quality over speed here. Make sure we're on balance, good. It's efficient with our movement, excellent. Good, last four, Danielle, great job. Good, nice, coming in, cut off that angle. Great, good, all the way back. Crossover step, absorb, strong, good. Nice, last one, fire it at me. Good, and relax, awesome. So three great progressions you can do with the medicine ball. And again, endless possibilities you can do with this, but this is kind of a three-step progression where you can work on your strength, your balance, and your efficiency of movement. Thanks for checking out this medicine ball routine video. If you want to learn more, always come to tenniswarehouse.com.